Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Tetiana Balanova, Community Coordinator, Association of Ukrainians in Great Britain in Edinburgh.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you for the opportunity to address you today. Today, I want to tell you about a country which is fighting for its right to exist. Ukrainians are being killed, tortured, raped. Our citizens' homes are being destroyed. Russia is trying to erase us as a nation. It has been trying to assimilate our language and culture for decades. When Ukrainian territories came under the control of the Russian Empire, printing of books in Ukrainian was forbidden, and all state documents were ordered to be rewritten in Russian. The process of the so-called Russification of Ukraine began. Over 400 years, Ukrainian language has been banned 134 times. The Stalinist terror of the late 1920s, 1930s, when prominent linguists and scientists were sent to labor camps or shot, went down in history under the name Executed Renaissance. No language has ever experienced such terrible destruction and persecution as Ukrainian. For all nations, language is a means of communication, but for us, because of the Russian state propaganda, it's a sign of nationalism, separatism, the cause of conflicts, and moral trauma. In the 21st century, the struggle for the chance to speak Ukrainian remains. Russian military strikes missiles at our schools and theaters. They believe that if somebody can speak Russian, they are their property. Russian language in Ukraine is a reason for Russia to constantly encroach on our territory. That is why we abandon everything related to Russia, especially its language. With the beginning of the war, some words changed their meaning. Here in a clear sky, you probably think about the clear sky and the good weather, but for us, a clear sky is the all-clear signal. When you hear the word arrival, you think about a plane being landed. For Ukrainians, arrival means Russian missiles whose targets are civilians. The casual, "How are you?" in Ukrainian means "Як ти?" became a new way of saying, "I love you and I care about you." For all of us, Russian language in Ukraine ended with the attacks on Bucha, Mariupol, Kharkiv, and hundreds of other cities similarly attacked. After hundreds of years of repression, to speak Ukrainian today is a conscious act of decolonization. Protect your mother language, speak it, and teach your children. Because language disappears, not because it's not taught by others, but because it's not spoken by those who know it. Ukraine was, Ukraine is, and Ukraine will be. Slava Ukraini!
Thank you, Tetiana. Thank you.